Hey guys, so what I'm working on is a yard roller. I was looking for one for a long time, never could find a decent deal on one. Everybody wanted a couple grand for a decent big, you know, yard roller. So my buddy Andy got this piece of pipeline pipe off somebody for I think around 200 bucks, and it's half inch thick, it's 30 inches in diameter, and then it's about 5 foot 7 inches wide. I went out and I drew up a couple end caps, and I had a local fab shop cut those out of 3/8, and they used the water jet, turned out real nice. And I had them cut a couple holes in the center, which I'm going to weld these tractor hubs into. I'm going to weld it up here, and then on the outside here I'm going to bolt basically some plate and come off that somehow and make a hitch. Haven't figured that all out yet, but I'm going to get the roller itself together with the tractor hubs in, and then I'm going to work my way forward from there. So what I did was I stuck this is for a hydraulic cylinder on a piece of equipment. You can stick this in there just to stop so you might not, so it doesn't drop all the way down to the ground. You can put a couple or three or four in. But what I'm going to do is use it as a stop for that plate, and then I'm going to grind around here, clean this all up. I'm going to set that plate on there, and hopefully it'll stay without tipping over. It should be pretty balanced, but then I'm going to weld around the outside on the top, pop that off, and then I'll weld underneath here, and then I'll have a small gap so that this outside of the hub is able to spin freely. So that's the plan, and then I'll weld them around here. I got to clean this up, it's been sitting out, but it's nice and smooth, so it shouldn't take long at all to clean that up and see where it goes. So those are both welded in. Definitely gonna add probably 3 gussets just to stiffen that up, because that's gonna have a lot of stress on it. As the tongue comes out and the tractor's pulling on it, it's gonna be really heavy. So I'm gonna do that on each of them. So I'll cut some pieces for that and weld those in. I think next I'm gonna clean up around the edge of the pipe here so that that's ready to weld as soon as I get those gussets on. Got some bracing welded on the back of these. Did 3 braces there just to stiffen it up. Hopefully it doesn't. All the torque's gonna be here. You know, you're gonna be pulling with the tractor. The tongue's gonna come off this around the front of the roller to the other one, and then into the middle on the tongue of the tractor. So tried stiffening those up. This is going inside, obviously, getting welded to the pipe there. So I guess I'm ready to start welding that. I'm gonna put a plug in for water so I can fill it, but I can do that whenever. I can do that when I'm done. Put it at the bottom or the top, whatever. Just someplace where you can roll it around and let the water drain out before winter. Face it downhill, let all the water come out or else it'll freeze and break all my mediocre welds. So I don't know, it's going all right so far. Might have done a few things different if it was a work job and I was spending work's money instead of my own, but we'll see how it goes together. I still gotta clean this end up. So they cut these at a miter so that the pipes fit together. This end is mitered out, the other one in, beveled in, whatever you want to call it. So I gotta clean this side up, but I can start welding that side on, and it's gonna be a lot of wire. Hopefully I got enough here. I don't think I got plenty, but it's still gonna be a lot of welding. I'm gonna have to open the door. It's gonna get pretty smoky in here, so see how it goes. Alright guys, got the other side welded on. Ended up breaking my welder, or it broke on me. Come to find out the circuit board went bad. You'd pull the trigger and it wouldn't feed wire. So had a guy help me troubleshoot it, and we narrowed it down to the circuit board. It was like $250 for a new circuit board. But it's working now. So anyway, Got both sides, both end caps welded on. Don't look the prettiest. I gotta do some weld or grinding and fill in a couple spots, but what I did here was I welded two pieces, 28 inches, and then this piece is like 88 inches, it'll span from one hub to the other hub. And I haven't completely figured out how I'm gonna mount it to the hub. Yeah, I'm thinking some U-bolts, kind of like you'd mount a axle on a Jeep to a set of springs. So still working that out, like I said, but we'll get something figured out. I had a couple U-bolts, I think, from an old Jeep lift kit that'll work, but I've only got two. I'd like to put two on each side, obviously, so might have to get a couple more. Anyway, we'll cross that road when we get there. So I'm gonna tack this in place, hopefully get it square. I'm just gonna tack everything and then take it over and fit it up, make sure it looks square and it's sitting in the right spot on the hubs, and we'll go from there. So I kind of went nuts without the camera there for about an hour, but I ended up, I think I can just use the two U-bolts. There's already a hole right here in one of these, and it gave me the idea, why don't I just put the U-bolt right in the center of this rectangular tubing, and then I can just use one on each side. So I drilled a bunch of holes on both sides here. Thinking that might work. I'm gonna give it a shot. So probably gonna quit for the night, but tomorrow I'm gonna put plate in here, brace all that up, and then probably wheel this back. I gotta cut this off because I ended up making it 10 inches too long. Can't measure apparently. And then I'll build my tongue off the front. I'll probably put this on a jack stand and get a jack or jack stand or something to set my tongue up on, and I can just work on it up off the floor. So I need to get bolts or nuts for these U-bolts tomorrow. They're fine thread. I don't think I have any. Haven't checked yet, but I'm pretty sure I don't. So it's coming along. Then I got to put a plug in, fill it with water, and then take it for a burn, see if she holds up. It's pretty heavy, so I'm hoping it does, but I guess we'll find out. So we'll see you tomorrow. Alright, so I got the U-bolts bolted on. Everything swings pretty good. Flips right over, which is a good sign. And then I welded. These are butt welded, so I spent the last probably hour and a half. My grinder, 6 amp. It's not fun cutting half inch plate, but I had it laying around. So I'm gonna brace the corners with that. And then I had these two pieces laying around from an old haybine tongue. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this hole for one of these. I'm gonna cut this off here, mount this flat one on top. This one's skinny enough, it'll slide in there, and then I'll catch this bolt through there, and then one of my bolts is done through this tongue piece. I'll have to locate the last one. Drill this out, put the second bolt in, and then I guess that'll be my hitch. And then I'm gonna cut this probably 4 foot long. Set the jack stands up, weld that on, and then I will probably brace that somehow. I haven't figured it out just yet. Probably just cut pieces of this and angle it out to the tongue from both sides. So we'll see how that works. But I'm gonna get it welded on and then see what it looks like. So we're getting close. Had to restock. Went through about 10 of these cutting that half inch plate. I really need a plasma cutter. And then got the Genesee. It's a must when you're doing stuff like this. Alright, so skip forward a few steps here. Get the camera off the tripod here. So, definitely skipped forward a few steps. I used this tongue off my haybine. It was a spare, I bought a parts haybine, and I took the whole tongue off, but these pieces bolted on. Top and bottom, so I took those off and bolted those onto this, stuck one inside this 2.5 by 2.5 inch tube and put the other one on the bottom and put two bolts on. So that worked out really nice. Ended up bracing this with the same 2.5 by 2.5 inch tubing. This is 2x3 tubing. It was 2 inches this way and this is 2.5, so had to do a little bit of fill welding around there. But it turned out pretty good. So overall it worked really well. I've used it probably 3 or 4 times now. No issues. Learned a lot welding that I can apply to the next project. Some of the thicker stuff, I had it on the low voltage setting. You can plug the lead into two different outlets or ports, whatever you want to call them. One is for low voltage and one is for high. And then you still have your heat setting for both. But as soon as I started using that high voltage setting, it would really burn into some of the thicker stuff. So wish I would have known that when I was welding the plates on the end. But again, I'd never used... Really, I haven't used a welder in general very much, let alone this welder in particular. So, just
fabrication stuff. I'm not a metal fabricator by any means. As I go, I'll learn, I'm sure, shortcuts and different tips and tricks. But looking forward to using the roller, keep the yard kind of smooth or rolling food plots, and think it'll be a good piece of equipment to have around. Definitely very handy. So thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the next one.